Hey, welcome back guys, this is your friend Shan. So today, you know, this video is going to be a really interesting video. It's about engineering program. My name is Sayed Shazib Hassan. I never told you my name properly, so my name is Sayed Shazib Hassan again. I'm doing mechanical engineering here at Memorial University of Newfoundland. That's an awesome university where you will meet different kinds of people, different kinds of program are there. So it's really great university, which I'm going to talk about in this video. So watch this video till the end. And let's see what's the temperature today. So if it's good, then we'll go outside and do the shoot outside. So let's see. Hey Google, what's the weather like today?
Today in St. John's, it'll be partly cloudy with a forecasted high of 16 and a low of 9. Oh. It's currently 16 degrees and partly cloudy.
Oh, that's 16 degrees. So that's an awesome temperature. So let's check the wind speed. Hey Google, what's the wind speed?
Today in St. John's, the wind is forecast to come from the south at 19 kilometers per hour.
That's awesome. So let's go outside and do the shoot. Okay guys, as you can see, weather is absolutely awesome. So let's go on the top of the mountain and let's shoot video over there. So let's go. Okay guys, so we are now at the top of the mountain, so let me show you the view from here. So let's go. Okay guys, so let's get back to the topic. So our topic for today is engineering program in general. So I'm gonna divide this video into three parts. Number one is engineering program in general, number two is requirements, number three is tips and tricks. Let's talk about engineering program in general first. So let me tell you why you should join Memorial University for engineering program. The number one reason is teaching is absolutely great. All the teachers, instructors, teaching assistants, they really help you in whichever help you need. For example, you are stuck with the problem, they will guide you throughout the problem, they will show you how to solve that and everything. In the campus you will find a lot of success centers and help centers where you will get the chance to improve your math, science or engineering subjects. All the professors and teaching assistants will really guide you throughout the program so that you get enough knowledge to make strong base in your first year, so that in the next year you don't need any guidance or anything to get going. So they really help you a lot. So study in engineering program is mostly technical, so they will give you different kinds of projects. So in my case, I'm doing mechanical engineering, so I usually get design projects, or usually I need to work on SolidWorks modeling things and then 3D printed it. Usually I have done lots of projects on that because my work is mostly on design projects. So that's it. So these projects really help you boost your resume, make it more polishable. So when you go to the industries to get a job, then these projects will definitely help you in getting the job. So it's really good thing. So engineering program in general is about 4.5 years long, which consists of 8 study terms and 6 work terms. So from 6 work terms, you need to complete at least 4 work terms in order to get your degree. So first year in engineering program is general, which has 11 subjects containing all the science and maths courses. So that is pretty easy. But and in the first year you don't choose your major. So in the first year you take basic courses, you do studies with all the engineering students, and then in the second year you get a chance to choose your major. And work term starts from the first year, so first 2 semesters study and then work term. then study, work term, then study, work term. It alternates between work terms and study terms. I'll attach the chart of the whole program in the description below, so you can check that out if you want to know more about how engineering program is structured. As I told you guys, in engineering program, work terms are mandatory. You need to complete at least 4 work terms in order to get your degree. So guys, it's not easy to get a work term. So cooperative education in Memorial University is there to help you get ready for the work term. They will help you boost your resume, make really perfect cover letters. So they will guide you throughout your work terms. So they are really helpful, guys. I have made a detailed video on cooperative education where I have explained everything what you need to know about getting work terms. So how to boost your resume, how to make cover letters. So everything is there. So you should check it out on my channel. So in engineering program, you need to make a lot of connections. So connections are really important part of engineering program. So if you want to get your internship or if you want to secure your job in the future, so you need to make some connections. So the thing I want to let you know is Memorial University really helps you make connections with the senior students, with employers, in order for you to get success in future, make connections and progress and get the job. So guys, let's talk about requirements to get into engineering program. In engineering program, you need to get at least 6.5 band in IELTS in order to secure your admission, along with 80% in science subjects and maths. Maths should be calculus. So 80% in science subjects and maths, and you need 6.5 band in IELTS exam in order to secure your admission in engineering program. Whether it's computer science, computer engineering, or mechanical engineering, electrical, or whatever. But in the engineering one, first year admission, you need to get 6.5 in IELTS, I repeat, and 80% in maths and science subjects. So after completing first year of engineering, then you need to get really good grades in order for you to get your preferred major. So in the first year of engineering, you need to get at least 60% average in all the subjects in order to qualify for work terms or in order to qualify for the major. So in the second year, you decide your major. So if you got 70% in as an average in first year, then you can choose whichever major you want: mechanical, electrical, computer, process, ocean, naval, any one of them. But if you have less percentage, then there is less chance to get your preferred major. So I'll definitely recommend you to get more than 80% in first year courses in order to secure your major. So if you want to do mechanical or computer, mechanical, let me tell you, for me, mechanical and computer was the toughest one to get into. So I'm doing mechanical engineering, so at that time I had to get 70% in my first year in order to qualify, in order to get our preferred major. So I got 84% in my first year, so that was easy for me to get my preferred major. But if you get 70% or 60% or 55%, then there is less chances for you to get your preferred major. So I'll definitely recommend you get more than 80% in your first year. So after requirements, let's talk about some tips and tricks. So my number one tip will be to get 7.5 band in IELTS so that you can secure your seat in engineering program. My second tip will be to get more than 80% in maths, chemistry, and physics in order to secure your seat. So if you get more than 80%, like 85 or 90, better, higher the better. So if you get more grades, like more than 80%, then there is more chances for you to secure your seat in the engineering program. So after getting your admission, my third tip will be to work really hard in your first year so that you can get your preferred major and get a chance to do your work terms and graduate. So my fourth tip will be, if you are going to do your high school, then go for O levels, A levels, because that's worldwide recognized. So in Memorial University, if you have done A levels or O levels in your high school, then you get most of the course, first year course credits. My fifth tip will be to start working on your cover letters, do some part-time work, so in order for you to gain some knowledge or some experience for writing your cover letter resume. So when you come here and go for the work terms, then you will already know some basics of writing cover letters and resume, then it's gonna be really helpful for you in the future. My sixth tip will be to let yourself know why you want to be an engineer why you are interested in engineering program in general, or what majors you are really interested in and why is that. Because if you don't know that reason, then it's gonna be really difficult when you come and do the engineering. Because I have seen many students, they are doing engineering because of their family or because of their personal reasons or without their interest. So they really find it hard for them like to get involved in engineering. So I really recommend you to do a detailed search so that you should know that why you are doing engineering. So guys, my final tip will be to apply as early as possible in order to secure your seat. So if you apply, if you wait till the deadline, so it's going to be really hard for you to get the admission. So I'll definitely recommend you to get your documents ready and apply as soon as possible in order to secure your seat in engineering program in first year of engineering. So that's it. So that's it for today guys. So if you like the video, you know what to do. Give it a big thumbs up. Share this video with your friends who want to join Memorial University or who are planning to join Memorial University for engineering program so that they can get some help from this video. So that's it for today. So see you next time.